So what is dopamine and why do you need to know more about it? Dopamine is one of the most important chemicals in the human brain. It's a neurotransmitter and a neuromodulator, and it is released at 3 or 4 critical parts of the human brain circuitry. Very often, dopamine is referred to as the reward chemical, and that's not necessarily entirely true. Dopamine is the chemical that is responsible for motivation and drive primarily. And the secondary benefit of dopamine is the reward, the feeling of pleasure when you achieve something or get something or do something that you derive pleasure from. Now, why is this important and why should you know about it? So, nowadays, we live in a world where we're surrounded by hundreds of distractions. Food, entertainment, social media, everything has become very easy to access. And that has caused a huge amount of addiction-related issues. And that has led to many mental health problems in people who get addicted. Now, it's important to understand why this happens and what we can do as individuals to modulate this. Dopamine is released from a part of the brain called the ventral tegmental area, and then it goes towards what is called the mesolimbic and the mesocortical pathways. And these are important to understand because it tells us how dopamine really works and why it works in such a way. So when dopamine reaches the mesolimbic part of the amygdala, which is the part of the brain that's responsible for emotions, such as fear, anxiety, happiness, pleasure, etc. The moment that dopamine is released in response to an external stimuli, the amygdala immediately associates the dopamine with a feeling of pleasure. So let us say that we eat a piece of chocolate, and dopamine gets released from the ventral tegmental area, and then it stimulates the region known as the amygdala, and that circuits on to a part of the brain called the hippocampus, which is responsible for memory. So therefore, the brain then begins to correlate chocolate with pleasure, and it keeps seeking out this reward over and over again. And that is what leads to craving. And now you understand why dopamine is the molecule responsible for craving. Now, dopamine works by working on certain receptors, which are like car parking spots in neurons. So when dopamine is released from one neuron, it attaches onto the other neurons, and these car parking spots is where dopamine attaches to and then triggers off a response in the neuron further down the line. Too much of dopamine causes these car parking spots to become full and insensitive over a period of time. It also causes depletion of the dopamine stores in our neurons. So every time you seek dopamine in the form of a reward or a pleasurable activity, if you seek it too often, repeatedly, and too close together, then that causes a depletion of your dopamine and an insensitivity of the car parking spots on the neuron beyond where dopamine is released. What this ultimately leads to is that you no longer feel the happiness or pleasure that you derive when you did that activity for the first time. And therefore, you need that activity to be much more intense, much stronger, to elicit the same feeling of pleasure that you had on the first time you did it. I hope I'm making myself clear. So basically, it's a law of diminishing returns with dopamine. So the more frequently you indulge in something pleasurable or something that releases dopamine in your brain, each successive time, you're going to derive less and less pleasure from it. So it's always a good idea to make sure that you space out that dopamine spike that you get from pleasurable activities. This can enhance the feeling of pleasure you get from the same activity if it's interspersed with a bit of a gap so that your dopamine levels can reach their normal baseline function. The other important thing about dopamine is that once it's released in very large quantities and then there's a depletion of the dopamine in the neurons, then your dopamine levels actually fall below baseline. And that can lead to a feeling of sadness and depression. And this is what we often see sometimes in addicts who when they're not able to get the same pleasure out of a dose of a drug, then they tend to go into the opposite side, which is they sink into a state of despair and depression, and it becomes very difficult. There's another molecule called serotonin, which is responsible not so much for pleasure, but for happiness. And too much of dopamine actually does affect the serotonin levels in the brain as well, which can further exacerbate the feelings of depression and despair that you see in addicts. Now, how do you modulate your dopamine, and why is it important to know how to modulate this? Like I said, there are hundreds of distractions in today's modern world, whether it be food, entertainment, social media, and so on and so forth. And it's important for us to realize that our reaction to certain things, if it's too ecstatic, too euphoric, then that can lead to a very large spike in dopamine, which will not serve us well in the long run. The other thing is that very often, dopamine is released in response to the expectation or the anticipation of a reward more than the reward itself. You may have encountered this yourself sometimes, that you're, let's say you're getting ready to go for a movie with your friends, but the anticipation of actually going for the movie is so much more pleasurable than sitting in the movie theater and actually watching the movie. And that is called the reward prediction error of dopamine. So you have to be able to understand what dopamine is doing to your thoughts and your perceptions. And this understanding will probably help you better modulate your response to all the multiple distractions that we have in the world. Don't get me wrong. Dopamine is a great molecule. We all need it. You only have to see a patient who doesn't have enough dopamine in their brains. So these are the typical patients that we see in our clinic with Parkinson's disease. They are depressed. They can barely move. They can't speak. They have tremors. So that's how devastating a complete lack of dopamine can be. And I'm not suggesting at all that you should not have any dopamine in your brain. In fact, part of joy of living is to feel that reward that you get from certain pleasurable activities. Just don't overdo it. So I really hope you liked visiting my channel on YouTube and you liked the videos I've posted. If you're from Instagram, thank you for clicking on that link and joining me here as well. I look forward to providing you more and more interesting and informative content in the days to come. And it'll be a great help if you can subscribe to my channel and click the bell icon for notifications on YouTube. That'll go a long way in supporting our work and the channel here. Thank you.